Hi, willkommen beim Lukas Filmgespräch zu Lilith und die Geisterjäger. Dafür haben wir Michael und Andrew van Ostade zu Gast, die Regisseure und Drehbuchautoren. Ihr könnt den Film sehen bei der kommenden Ausgabe von Lukas, Internationales Festival für junge Filmfans, vom 6. bis zum 13. Oktober 2022 in Kinos in Frankfurt, Offenbach und Wiesbaden. Er ist Teil des Wettbewerbs 8+. Neben mir sitzen Milan und Oskar, die den Film bereits gesehen haben und sich einige Fragen überlegt haben, um euch neugierig zu machen. Ich bin Simon vom Lukas-Team und ich würde sagen, dann fangen wir doch direkt an. Ja, wir haben jetzt Michael und Andrew van Ostade zugeschaltet. Herzlich willkommen bei Lukas. Bevor wir mit den Fragen jetzt anfangen, könntet ihr uns ein bisschen was über den Film erzählen? Wie würdet ihr ihn beschreiben?
Well, basically, me and Andrew, we saw the same movies as kids. And we just love ghosts and paranormal stuff a lot. And we noticed that, like, there weren't a lot of movies being made that were also for children. We felt like kids need more movies to celebrate Halloween. Here in Belgium, we noticed that like, a lot of cinemas did scary movie nights, but they were movies that, like, were actually not intended for children, so we felt obligated to change that, especially here in Flanders, in Belgium. I think we're pretty much the first ghost movie ever made.
That's maybe a good tagline, probably the first ghost movie of Flanders.
That's the main reason we wanted to make this movie, and it's a fun but still scary movie. Like, the best word in Dutch would be griezelen, so I wonder if there's a good German word for what we try to do. It's supposed to be scary, but still fun. Is there a good German word? Can you guys help us out?
Also gruselig, aber witzig. Witzig. Wenn ich sagen. Auch in Englisch, denke ich gerade.
Gruselig sounded good.
Yeah, I like gruselig. Andrew, maybe you can say something about, like, what the story is about.
The story is about a young girl who gets sent to a boarding school. And there she meets friends who all have very special characteristics. And she notices many of the kids have something going on. And she's a detective, so she wants to find out more. And she thinks it's something spooky and paranormal. So she calls the two people she knows, and that's the Ghastly Brothers, and that's played by us, who go from door to door and bust ghosts in their own special way. And they will find out that maybe there's something more to those ghosts than just creepy. Maybe there's something from inside that wants to say something about how they feel.
Lilith, heb jij je koffer al gepakt?
Ik ga niet naar dat internaat.
Koffer? Nu.
Oh, kotschool.
Het gaat gewoon niet anders.
Dag, ik ben Marco. Jij bent Lilith. Dat is Casper. Casper is echt keigrappig.
Okay, jetzt würde ich dann an euch beide weitergeben. Dann könnt ihr quasi mit euren Fragen starten.
Wie sind Sie auf den Filmtitel gekommen und spielen die Gebrüder Schimm auf die Gebrüder Grimm an?
Absolutely. I think Michael can say more about the title because he thought about it.
Yeah, I'm the one that likes to make the silly jokes with words. We call them like Wortspelletjes.
Wortspiele,
ja. Wortspiele. And we were looking for a title, and I remember it is based on the Gebrüders Grimm. And I just remember Schim, I don't know what it might mean in German, but Schim for us is a shadow. That title, as soon as we put it on paper, like on the script, like the Gebrüder Schim version 1, we were like, okay, this is the title. This is going to stay forever. It's just perfect.
Over enkele dagen hebben wij een jobdag. Heeft iedereen zijn jobkeuze ingeleverd?
Paranormale detectieven?
Wie was dat? Spoken en monsters bestaan niet.
Jawel, er zijn spookjagers.
Nou, ik zal eens horen bij die schimmelbroeders.
Denk jij dat dat gaat werken?
Gibt es Anspielungen auf andere Filme, zum Beispiel Ghostbusters oder Alles steht Kopf?
See, the best way to put it is me and Andrew, we're like a sponge and we just absorb everything in our lives, all the movies we watch, and then we make something. And always after the fact, when the movie's finished, people ask us like, oh, that was a reference to that movie. And we're like, yes, yes. And we're like, I guess we just ripped off another movie. But there are references that we really put in there because we thought it was fun. For example, the school is called Saint-Rémy, which is translated to Saint Rémy. But there's also a famous horror director called Sam Raimi. So those are fun little nods for like your parents. When you go to the movies with your parents, they possibly saw like a Sam Raimi movie.
Or also for me.
Like we noticed that like our two biggest like audiences are young kids who love it, but also like the parents of young kids who are also still a little bit like the kids, but they don't want to admit it. So they remember the movies that they watched when they were children. So there are a lot of references in there.
We always found an enormous passion for the Laika animation studio. We always said that if we had a dream to make a movie, it would be a live action Laika movie. And one of the movies that really inspired us is Paranorman. It's a movie that was close to us because all the characters had so much personality. And the final scene is about a dialogue between two people. And it's also there in Paranorman that you feel that you can have a very special, spectacular ending. And it's just two people talking about their emotions.
War ist das erste Mal, dass sie in einem Film mitgespielt haben.
I'm actually not really an actor. I'm more of a director and a writer. But I remember when we pitched the movie to like investors or producers, we would always be very like energetic and we would talk about the brothers. But we never thought that we would play the brothers. But at the end of the meeting, they would say, oh, I love this idea. It's great. But you guys are going to play the brothers, right? And always we'd think, okay, maybe. But there was this certain dynamic between us that's really there because we are actually brothers. Andrew has been acting for, I'm going to say at least 10 to 15 years.
Wo wurden die verschiedenen Szenen gedreht und gibt es das Internat wirklich?
It's actually interesting. The boarding school does exist, but we shot a lot of sequences in other schools because we wanted to make like this really cool school, like for example, where they have like the job day where they can see like career options. But one of the more interesting like locations is we were looking for the home of the brothers, and we went on location scouting and we saw a few fun things and we were like, oh, it's okay. But then we drove past this really creepy actual ghost house. And we were like, we want to shoot there. That's the place we want to shoot. And the guy was like, I'm sorry, you're going to smash it. They're going to completely destroy that house. So we said like, please, could you like wait before you destroy this house? Because we would like to shoot there. And in that house, we shot so much stuff. We shot the brother's house. We shot parts of the school. It was such a big, huge mansion. But now that house has been completely destroyed, so we were the last people to be able to shoot there.
Was für ein Haus war das Haus ganz am Anfang des Films? Also das, was vor dem IKEA kam?
Well, that house doesn't exist. It's CGI based on a model that was made. But we liked the idea of, okay, we're making a movie about ghosts, so obviously there needs to be a very scary house. And then during the writing, we thought like, what would be a place that could feel very homely, that would have like interiors of a house, but would be totally weird if it had a ghost in it. And then we thought like, oh, the IKEA is perfect because it has like a sitting room, a living. And then we thought about the character of the couch that comes to life. And then it was just, this is perfect. This is surprising. This is not your typical ghost hunting session.
Wout?
Ja?
Gib eine Wahrnehmung.
spoken?
Ja, overal.
Wie schwer war es, die Geister und Dämonen zu kreieren? Und wie sind sie auf das Geisterdesign gekommen?
I think every single ghost started as a pun, like a wordplay. Because it's such a little pun, fun thing, it was very easy to conceptualize, okay, we want a white spirit. Eh? So that would be like a classical white ghost or the couch that comes to life in the IKEA. But the hardest part was that we wanted to do it practical. Today, everything is done like CGI and stuff, but we wanted to make it real because it also harbors back to the movies that we saw as kids. Plus, it was a lot more fun for the actors, us, and also the kids to like interact with something that was really there. So yeah, it was a lot of work. I would even say harder than if we would make them in a computer or with CGI.
Welche Geister und oder Dämonen haben Ihnen am besten gefallen?
I'm really proud of the IKEA sofa. And the white spirits, I think, are my two favorites. But those are like the ones that are big moments in the story.
I can't choose. Just that's like asking who is your favorite child.
Yeah.
So no, I abstain.
Warum mag Margot so gerne Schnecken?
Why?
Why? I mean, why? I have no idea. Why does Margot like snails so much? The funny thing is, this is like our second movie, but the first movie we made was for different people. This is our own movie, but this is the second time we put snails in our movie. So maybe we secretly like snails and we just don't know it. But we just wanted something that was quirky for her. Mm-hmm. And the idea of a snail circus, because I does that exist? I remember, like, I know like a flea circus. But when we were brainstorming and writing the script, we were like, oh, and Margot could have a snail circus. And we don't know, does this exist? Did we just make this up? Is this a reference to something? We don't know. But it just made so much sense that Margot would have like, yeah, a circus of snails. Why? We should ask her.
Welche Botschaft steckt hinter der Mutter-Tochter-Beziehung und deren Streit?
If you think about the demons, they are emotions that you hide. And for Lilith, it's she feels that she's being abandoned by her mother, while the mother just wants to pursue a very interesting moment in her career. And so that's the conflict between the two, is that the mother needs to work and thinks that the school is really good for her, which is also really good for Lilith. It's not a bad school. It's a nice school where she can really develop all her skills. But Lilith feels like you just leave me behind.
But I think one of the most important parts of the dynamic between Lilith and her mother is we noticed in a lot of movies that there's always this guilt that the parents get when they have an opportunity. Maybe your mother has this opportunity to go study a strange bird in a faraway place. But oh no, they can't because they have children. And when you have children, you can't have a career or you can't have a life. And we don't agree. We think you can still have, a mother should still be allowed to develop or blossom. It's not because you have children that suddenly your ambitions should stop. And that was very important for us. And children understand that.
Haben die Produktion und die Requisiten, zum Beispiel die Geisterjäger-Sachen, viel gekostet?
It was extremely cheap. I mean, it's when you have a budget, you can put a lot of time in outsourcing it. But we had such a good production team that they could just use like trash and put it together, and it would look fun and silly. Like, I have props. Wait, just one second. This is Hans, his sixth sense, but it's basically all glued together with pieces that you could find in like a trash. And some parts are like 3D printed. So it was made cheap, but the labor and the love, that was the expensive part.
I think you have this, the sports store Decathlon in Germany.
Yeah, we have it in Germany as well. Yeah,
it's a helmet from Decathlon, and then everything attached to it.
And we love the props. That's why we keep them. We stole them from the set.
Wie lang hat die gesamte Produktion des Films gedauert?
The whole movie took us 7 years, but it is from the idea to the writing to the looking for money to get the movie made. It took us 7 years. The funny thing was, one of the reasons we as a first production from Belgium was allowed to film again, because if we waited longer, you could immediately see that the kids had a lower voice or were bigger or completely trained.
Hat Ihnen der Dreh Spaß gemacht?
We had so much fun that it was difficult to not laugh during every scene.
I think there was one scene where I had to grab Andrew and say, like, did you remember what happened last time? I think we did that take like 23 times. Because every time I grabbed Andrew, he started laughing. And I think I grabbed you so much that you started having pain. On your chest, because we had to do it so much times, but it just was it was so much fun.
I have an important question for the kids.
Yeah, sure.
Was ist dein Lieblingsfilm?
Genau wie die Frage, was ist dein Lieblingskind? So viele.
I understood that answer.
I have really, really much favorite films, mm-hmm. but your film is one of that.
All right. Oh. Yes.
What was your favorite scene of the movie? Yeah, the IKEA one. Mm. The IKEA scene. Mm. I really enjoyed how you thought of like throwing things that get lost in a sofa at the monster, at the ghost, the monster, defeat it. I found that very funny.
I think my favorite scene in the film is the scene where are you in your own house and with the ghost who has no head.
It's played by a German actor, the ghost. Yes, Gustav Koenigs, but he's mostly in theater.
If they would make an American remake, like Marvel blockbuster. Who would be the brothers?
I will cast Robert Downey Jr.
Mm-hmm.
and Johnny Depp.
Oh. Okay, cool.
Okay, wow. That would be nice. That would be nice.
I'll be Robert Downey Jr.
Is there anything else that you want to add for the Lucas audience out there?
To have a really good time. I mean, we will be there at the screenings. So please ask us questions. We don't bite hard. Take your whole family, because the movie has stuff that your grandpa would like, but also your crazy uncle would like.
Ja, vielen Dank für die tollen Antworten, die ihr gegeben habt. Wir freuen uns ganz stark darauf, dass ihr zum Lucasfilm Festival kommt im Oktober, auch in Person. Thank you so much for your time and see you in Frankfurt then in October.
Yes.
Yep. All right.
Yes. Goodbye, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Have a nice day.
Ja, euch an den Bildschirmen, zu Hause und unterwegs, vielen Dank fürs Anschauen. Wir hoffen, ihr habt jetzt Lust bekommen, euch den Film bei Lucas anzusehen. Um Näheres zu erfahren, klickt auf unsere Webseite lucas-filmfestival.de und besucht unsere Social-Media-Kanäle. Zu guter Letzt noch der Dank ans Medienprojektzentrum Offener Kanal Rhein-Main, MOC, hier in Offenbach, für die Bereitstellung des Studios und natürlich an Milan und Oskar für die tollen Fragen und an das Team hinter der Kamera. Wir sehen uns dann beim Festival. Bis dahin!